Hello and welcome to Anden's channel, my channel. I just got home from work, and what do I see? I see that DC is planning to make a Joker origin story movie not related to the DC extended universe and not played by Jared Leto, but someone else. And it's gonna be set in the 80s. There's a whole lot of information that I just got dropped on me as soon as I walked in the front door. And since this is like right here, right now, very fresh in my mind when I found out about this, I thought, I have my camera ready and everything, I might as well make a video talking about it, because I'm just like, oof. Deadline reported that a Joker origin film is in early stages of development by Warner Brothers and DC, and it will be produced by Martin Scorsese, which honestly doesn't really mean that much. Being a producer only means that, you know, you give them money, basically. Like the Jeremy Johns video, I managed to see that as soon as I walked in the door. That's how I found out about this. I was just like, what's this, Jeremy Johns? Ah, shit, Joker. He made the comparison of Steven Spielberg being a producer for Transformers. So being a producer doesn't really tell you how good the movie will be depending on who's producing it. So no Jared Leto, not in the DC Extended Universe. It's a completely separate thing. It's basically an Elseworld story. And with this, apparently, they also announced that Jared Leto will still be in films like Suicide Squad 2 and maybe Gotham City Sirens, if these movies are even happening. We don't really know as of right now because we didn't hear about them during Comic-Con, but one would assume that those movies are probably gonna happen. It's going to be focused on an early 80s Gotham City with a hard-boiled crime feel. I am just gonna share my opinions about all of this. Even if this was connected to the extended universe, I would not be excited about this, honestly. I feel like a Joker origins film really defeats the purpose of the Joker. You know, everybody loves the Joker because we don't know his origin story. I mean, for me personally, the whole him falling into a vat of chemicals because of Batman, and then, you know, basically Batman creating the Joker and all of that, which is in, you know, the Killing Joke, and then it's in several of the video games, and then in the animated movies, and it's also hinted into several of the other movies and everything. I mean, that's my favorite. If you're gonna have an origin for the Joker, I really like that one. I have a feeling, however, that even though they say an origin story, they probably mean like the origin of the popularity of the Joker, of the rise of the Joker. I'm going to assume that when the movie starts, he's already the Joker, you know. That's what I'm picturing. Will Batman be in it, though? He basically has to be in it, because there would be no Joker without the Batman, and, you know, vice versa. Again, that's the whole thing I really love about Batman and the Joker, you know. So if you remove Batman from the equation, you know, you get Suicide Squad. I would be excited to see a new Joker. I wasn't a fan of Jared Leto's Joker. Nothing against his performance. I know a lot of people like to point out the whole where he had like a dragon tattoo or something, and just like, look at this, he had tattoos. Yes, but I hate his tattoos so much. I think that a damaged tattoo on his forehead is so unnecessary, because he is the Joker. Like, all of his tattoos, that's something his followers would have on their bodies. That's something that Harley Quinn would have on her body, which she does. Her having tattoos, you know, displaying her affection and love for her puddin', you know, all of that makes complete sense. But I feel like the Joker is the mastermind, who is the controlling person. Shouldn't have a tattoo on his forehead that says damage. I just don't think it was very well handled in Suicide Squad. Which is too bad, because you hear like all of the things that he did, you know, Jared Leto, not behind the scenes, but like on set, all of the things that they cut and all of that. Like, you're just like, shit, I you know, you can't. You know, you feel bad. I feel bad for Jared Leto. You know, he was promised one thing and he got something complete other. I honestly do not expect him to even show up in Suicide Squad or Gotham City Sirens. Not because DC or Warner Bros. Doesn't want him, but because he doesn't want to. Immediately after the movie was out, he was just talking shit about it. So in that regard, this solo origin story of the Joker actually does interest me more than seeing him again in Suicide Squad 2, which is weird because I'm not interested in seeing this movie right now. Of course, we literally know nothing about the story, we literally know nothing about who's playing him, we know nothing about nothing. All we have is a premise, and I don't really like the premise right now. As I said, this would be an Elseworld story, and you know, those are fun. Dark Knight Returns and all of that, you know, all of those are like Elseworld stories that people love, but I don't think an Elseworld story would work today, you know, in 2017. They would probably work in 2005 when the cinematic universes and the extended universes, when they didn't exist. But today, it's just too confusing, if you know what I mean. Not for us. Not for us who look at this information. Not for us who knows about it, but for the general audience. And unfortunately, even though we want the movies to cater to us fans as much as possible, you can't do that. You know, you just can't. You have to cater to the general audience. And the fact is, after seeing Suicide Squad, people are now expecting Jared Leto's Joker. And they are also expecting all of the DC movies to now be connected. So if you suddenly get a movie that's not connected, you know, it would be like if Marvel made, you know, a Captain America movie that's not connected, that's played by a different actor, that's played by, you know, it's all different. That would be really fucking confusing. So while I do like the idea of an Elseworld movie, and they apparently are planning to make more of these, but in my opinion, I don't think that these types of movies can work today. So all they have to do really is prove me wrong, and then I'll probably be excited. You know, if the trailer is fantastic, you know, I mean, if the movie looks good, I'm not gonna care if it's connected or not connected. I'm just stating, like, it's gonna be confusing, but if the movie's good, oh, then you also run into problems. Like, if the movie is really, really good and people love this version of the Joker, and then you have Jared Leto, which, let's be honest, even if you like him, he got a mixed response, you know? He got a really mixed response. So if people love this Joker, they're gonna wanna see him. They're not gonna wanna see Jared Leto. How is that not confusing? How is it not confusing for Jared Leto? Like, he's just like, oh, a Joker movie. I'm not playing it. What the fuck, DC? Like, you know? Yeah, I don't know. I've given you my thoughts on this standalone Joker movie. We don't know much about it. Hopefully we'll get some more information about what's gonna happen and if DC is indeed planning to make more of these. But yeah, hey, that's my opinion about all of this. What do you think about the Joker having his own movie not connected to anything and being set in the 80s? 80s Gotham. Sort of like the original Batman movie. Yeah. Tell me what you think in the comments, if you like it, if you not like it. And also, I will see you guys some other day. I love you all, and goodbye.